everyone, good morning. I'm Niladri and today we are going to discuss about the RATCH, why the RATCH is performed and what is the contention based random access and what is the non-contention based random access, as we just discussed in the last chapter. So we'll start with the reasons of RATCH or why RATCH is performed. The first reason is for initial access from RST idle state. If the UE want to some kind of uplink transmission, or it want to receive a downlink transmission, or it wants to do some initial access from idle state to connected state, or it want to perform a handover, or if the UE want to do some uplink synchronization, then for these five reasons the RATCH procedure is performed. We'll go again. Initial transmission from UE idle state, RRC connection re-establishment. If a re-establishment is required, then RATCH procedure will be performed. And for handover, for downlink data arrival during RRC connected and uplink data arrival during RRC connected if the UE is not synchronized or no PUCCH resource available for service request. So those are the five reasons for random access. And contention based random access is applicable for all these five reasons. But for non-contention based random access, in case of downlink data arrival during RRC connected or handover, for these two, three and fourth reason, we use non-contention based random access. So let's understand what is contention based and non-contention based random access. For that, let's see that call flow. PRATCH preamble, this is the UE, this is the inode B. So we send the preamble in the downlink. Node B sends PDSCH or the physical downlink shared channel, which gives us a random access response along with ID of the received preamble. Whatever preamble is sent by UE, we get that ID and uplink resources for transmission, uplink transmission resources on which subframe or particular resource the UE can transmit the physical uplink shared channel. And a temporary CRNTI, please note here, temporary in case of contention based random access in the second step. Then in the third step, UE sends the PUSCH or physical uplink shared channel. What information is sent? It sends the RRC connection request, it sends the CRNTI, that temporary, and the TIMC or MC, international mobile subscriber identity, or temporary mobile subscriber identity, or any random number, depend on the state the UE is. And in the fourth step, the PDSCH contention resolution, that means the CRNTI is allocated for the UE, that means for any further transmission, inode B gives a cell radio network temporary identity to the UE permanently. Here it is, here also we get a TIMC, sorry, CRNTI, but it is temporary, but this one is permanent during contention resolution. So now let's understand what is contention based and what is non-contention based random access. Basically, contention based means, as I told, for this five reasons contention based is performed. That means out of the 64 reserved preamble, we have some reserved preamble for contention based random access, and some are reserved for handover and downlink data arrival. That is a part of 64, but that is not in the reserved group for contention based. So non-contention based are those preambles which is a part of 64 preamble, but they don't come in the bucket of contention based random access. That means they are contention free or non-contention based. So some preambles is allocated by the E node B directly to the UE. So In case of non-contention based random access, the chance of collision is zero. But in case of contention based random access, there are still some chance of collision. So that's the basic difference. In contention based random access, always UE picks up a random preamble and start sending the PRATCH preamble to the eNode B. But in case of non-contention based, the first step is the eNode B sends a preamble number to the UE to communicate for further communication, and that happens only in two cases, handover and downlink, that are available during RRC connected state. So I hope you really enjoyed and understood the difference between contention based and non-contention based or contention free random access, and why random access is required to be performed, and where we are using non-contention based for handover and downlink data arrival during RRC connected state, and for all other five reasons we use contention based random access, and how the chance is zero in case of non-contention based random access, because the eNode B allocates that preamble ID to the UE initially to have the further communication. That is why the chance is zero for collision. So that's all for today. We'll catch you up very soon with a new one. Thank you so much, and bye bye for now.